In the last modules, we learned how to install Kali Linux and connect our wireless adapter to our Kali Linux machine. So in order to verify if our adapter is properly connected, I'll just verify if it is able to detect wireless devices. Okay, so our next step is to understand the tools that we will be using related to wireless security throughout our series. So 802.11 wireless tools are the tools which will be used for Wi-Fi security and Wi-Fi hacking. Note, Kali Linux also has tools related to Bluetooth, RFID, software-defined radio and other things. But here you can see there are lots of tools available. However, we won't be able to go into each and every one because it will be a very long lecture if we go into each and every one of those tools. One of those tools that we'll be going through is AirCrackNG. It is not just one tool, it consists of 20 other tools within it. Right? It is a very broad scale of tools available. Then we'll be looking into Kismet, we'll be looking into MDK3, and most probably we'll also be looking into the CowPatty. Anyways, so let's open our terminal, and I'm using green font. You can see I like green font much more better than that of white. So if you also want green font, you can go to edit, profile preferences, colors, and you can select green on black. By default it works white on black, but you can select green on black. Anyways, coming back to our module, if we look into the interfaces that are available right now, you can see I have WLAN 0 interface, which is basically used for wireless activities. But throughout our series, we won't be using WLAN 0 interface. So why is that? So let me give an example. I'll start Wireshark. And I'll use WLAN 0 interface and I'll select the packet capture. And here you can see it is not capturing any packet because by default WLAN 0 interface works on the IEEE 802.11 based stack, which is old. But nowadays there is a newer stack of MAC 802.11 which is supported by the latest kernel. One of the things that WLAN 0 won't allow us to do is it won't allow us to capture the traffic which is sent from other access points to other computers. It will only allow us to capture the traffic which is coming to our computer. But for wireless hacking and wireless security, we also have to capture traffic of other computers. Maybe for analysis. Not illegally, but you'll have to take permission from others before you start to capture the packets. So in order to do this, what we'll do is we'll run a command called as airmonng, I'll press enter, and note it is showing you only one interface. So what I'll do, I'll run airmonng, I'll start WLAN 0. So what basically it will do is it will create a monitor mode with the interface mon 0. So what mon 0 allows us to do is it works on the MAC 802.11 stack and it allows us to even capture traffic based on other interfaces. So let's see how it works. I'll run Wireshark again. And here there is a mon 0 interface. I'll click on it and I'll click start. And here you can see suddenly there is a lot of amount of traffic. Within 4 to 5 seconds there are so many packets that have come. And this is the reason why we'll be using mon 0 interface throughout our series. So if I run airmonng command again, you'll see there is a mon 0 interface that has been up and running. even if you can verify with the ifconfig command, and there is a Mozilla interface over here. Now, when I had started the Mozilla interface with this command, it gave a warning saying these three processes might create trouble in our security practicals. So what we will do is we will kill all these three processes. By kill, I mean we can stop it. So I'll run airmon ng, I'll do check, and it will show me the processes that can create trouble during the practical session. So I'll do airmon ng check kill. So what this will basically do is it will kill all the processes that can hamper our practical session. So we learned the basics about airmon ng. Now let's start with the basics behind aerodump ng. Aerodump ng, basically it will allow us to see the nearby Wi-Fi's in our vicinity. So the command is airmon ng followed by the interface, and we'll be using Mozilla interface. I'll let it run for a few seconds. And in order to stop it, you can press Ctrl C. Now, let's see what it has done. Basically, it is your ESSID denotes the name of the Wi-Fi which are available. This is the encryption scheme used by Wi-Fi. So you can see here it's using WEP. Rest all the three are using WPA2 encryption. You can see the channel in which the Wi-Fi's are running. So two wireless devices are running on one and two are running on seven channels. You can see if there is any data that is being exchanged, and here you can see these Wi-Fi's are idle. So maybe the owner have gone out of the office. This is the power related information, and this is the MAC address of the particular router. So what I'll do is I'll start my Cisco router, and then we can connect to it via aerodump ng. So I've started my Cisco router, and let's wait for a few seconds. So I'll clear the screen with the help of clear command, and I'll type aerodump ng followed by the Mozilla interface. Let's wait for some time. Okay. Lots of wireless devices detected. In my vicinity, there are hundreds of wireless devices. So if you really have a powerful antenna, say 1 watt, you can literally detect like 100 plus Wi-Fi devices. Anyways. So here you can see there is a device called as Cisco, which is using WPA2 encryption, and this is the MAC address. So the problem with aerodump command that we had typed earlier was it basically shows data related to all the Wi-Fi devices which are available. Now what if I want to just lock on to only one Wi-Fi devices, right? So if you're doing penetration testing on say only one device, then you do not need information of all the other devices. So in order to lock onto particular device, what I'll do, aerodump ng hyphen hyphen BSSID. BSSID is basically the MAC address of the particular router. So here you can see there is a field called as BSSID, and I'll copy this particular field. Followed by channel number. It is running on channel 5. And followed by the interface name. And once I do that, you can see over here it is giving me information specific to the Cisco router. It is not showing me any information related to the other Wi-Fi devices. So this is what I wanted to show you. We'll be running more commands related to the Aircrack NG suite. We have covered Airmon NG, we have covered Aerodump NG. There are a lot of commands like Aircrack NG, Airlib NG, etc. So for our practical session, these two commands is what I wanted to show you. And I hope you practice these two commands because we'll be using these two commands a lot in our future practical nuggets. Thank you very much for watching.